Hello, everybody, boys, girls, ladies, gentlemen, dudes, dudettes. Sergey Baklikov, and you're watching Baklikov Live. Here I'm bringing the live streams to the whole new level. This is IRL in real life. St. Petersburg, the center of St. Petersburg. I'm next to St. Isaac's Cathedral. An amazing St. Isaac's Cathedral. And right now, this Sunday night, we will go to the restaurants, Russian restaurants, intelligent Russian restaurants, and tapas bar, which is called Petrov-Vodkin. It's named after one of the most significant Soviet Russian artists, painters, you know, Kuzma Sergeyevich Petrov-Vodkin. He is really great. Meanwhile, you can check out one of his the most iconic artworks from 1912. It's called Bathing of a Red Horse. So the restaurants, Russian restaurants, Petrov-Vodkin is located in the very center. I mean, from one side there's St. Isaac's Cathedral, from another side there's a Winter Palace, and right in front of it there's an Admiralty. So let's go. Let's never waste the time. Local time it's like about 9:53, and my reservation there in only 7 minutes from now. Hi. Come on. Meanwhile, here is Angliter Hotel. There's Astoria. This is St. Isaac's Square. St. Isaac's itself. Coffee, which is called Happiness. I think this is the best coffee in terms of panoramic view to St. Isaac's. So keep in mind. This is Малая Морская, a small marine street. That's where Петр Чайковский used to live and died in 1893. Good to see the snow has gone. Yes, it's now plus 1 degrees Celsius. Also, a lot of street techniques worked here. I mean, all those cars which are cleaning the snow. And who knows, maybe that's when the real spring gonna come. You know, actually spring came already like several times. Spring was coming, but then the winter was getting back, like today. Today in the morning, I was making the driving tour. I was driving all over St. Petersburg, starting from Pulkovo International Airport. And dudes, I expected it would be just a nice day, but it was snowing all night today. So I'm going in direction of Admiralty, you see. Вознесенский проспект. This is the hotel called Sofitel, Вознесенский 6. By the way, I used to film here once and even went to their, how to say, penthouse, luxe. Filmed there. There's an absolutely amazing luxe with the panoramic windows. One window looking at, there's jacuzzi on a corner, and two windows. If you turn your head to the right, there's the dome of St. Isaac's Cathedral. If you look straight forward, there's Mariinsky Palace. Okay, this is Admiralty. Look, Indian cuisine. I still never came here since 1994. It's called tandoor, but I'm gonna fix it pretty soon. It's going to be my first experience with Indian food. Tandoor restaurant. Okay, so I've got two Admiralty Avenue, Admiralty Prospect, and that's where it's located, Petrov-Vodkin. Intelligent Russian restaurant, Russian cuisine restaurant, and tapas bar. Are you ready for Russian food? Also, here is Irish pub, which is called Radio Ireland. Trattoria Mario. If you will want Italian food, Mario. Piacere, Mario. And look, Petrov-Vodkin, Petrov-Vodkin. What an awesome location. Look, this is Petrov-Vodkin. There, just 100 meters from Petrov-Vodkin, Winter Palace, Palace Square. Right in front of Admiralty. And there, St. Isaac's Cathedral. And there, the residential building where used to live Pyotr Tchaikovsky. Okay, I can go. The green light. After one of the most significant Russian artists, Kuzma Sergeyevich Petrov-Vodkin.
А у меня 10 часов было бронирование. Сергей. Да, дверь-то вообще у вас. Спасибо.
Хоть деда можно съесть.
А, спасибо.
Не возражаете, да? Так, для влога.
Check it out. 1912. The most iconic work of Petrov-Vodkin. It's called Bathing of a Red Horse.
Yeah.
Ну вот тут около края присяду. Спасибо. Спасибо. А вот здесь англоязычное меню.
Найдется.
Спасибо.
Okay, waiting for a menu. Well, traditionally, at first I'm getting the menu, making a choice, then go to wash my frigging hands, and waiting for a food already. Okay, Kuzma Petrov-Vodkin. Kuzma Sergeyevich Petrov-Vodkin. He was born in 1878. He was born in a very small town, which is called Khvalinsk. This is Saratov region of Russia. It's not far from Samara, Khvalinsk. Спасибо. Khvalinsk. And he got a talent of an artist already in the childhood. However, even until the end of the middle school, he never thought about the serious career of an artist. So in the summer, after finishing the middle school, he got for a summer job to the shipyards, and then he wanted to get to railroad college. But fortunately, I wanted to say fortunately, he failed the exams. So that's what made him to continue the searchings as an artist. And finally, good luck. He got noticed and he was invited to St Petersburg to study an arts in a Byron Stieglitz school for an arts. So from 1895 to 1897 he studied the arts and painting here in St Petersburg at Byron Stieglitz school, and then he moved to Moscow, to the Moscow school for an architecture, sculpture and arts. And so that's how he gets a real real professional, and he found his own style. His style is really interesting. It's iconographic with a very creative, effects of the curve of the globe. So yeah, you can check out, for example, his pictures. One of the most iconic works, it's called Bathing of a Red Horse, 1912. It has become an instant classic, and this is now his trademark. I think that this is probably the most famous artwork of Petrov-Vodkin nowadays. And what you can see now on my thumbnail, it's actually a part of that picture, and just what I used to show you just like 5 minutes ago. Okay, Petrov-Vodkin. Look, already in 1910, he was discussed by two major painters back in those days, Alexandre Benois and Ilya Repin. In the moments when Alexandre Benois, was the defender of the creativity of Petrov-Vodkin, and Ilya Repin, vice versa, he was a critic. He criticized big time Petrov-Vodkin, big time. Unfortunately, died in 1939 because of tuberculosis. Damn. Well, he was relatively not that old yet, okay? Okay, so let's check the menu. I will check the menu and then we'll go to wash my freaking hands and we'll get back. Petrov-Vodkin. So the restaurant names after him. So here you will see like many pictures painted as by him, as his contemporaries.
Here is an interior of like the institutions back in those days, in the end of 19th, beginning of 20th century. And what I really love that here is the music, which is like really Russian music of those days. Okay, the menu. Let's look at the menu. Petrov-Vodkin. Okay, tapas. Herring with marinated onions, egg, and mustard on rye bread. Herring forschmack on rye bread. Smoked roast pork on hearth. Breads with homemade horseradish, salo, which is cured pork fat on Borodino breads with Russian mustards, chicken liver pate with stewed beetroot and caramelized onion, salted onegin white fish on Borodino bread, spreads on Borodino breads with egg pate, Baltic spreads with slice of lemon on Borodino breads, sausage from Krakow on rye breads, assorted five types of tapas with homemade vodka by chef recommendation, salo, cured pork fat, bread, horseradish with dill steam, vodka, herring on rye breads, caraway vodka, chicken liver pate, cherry and clove liquor, sausage from Krakow on rye bread, anise and cranberry vodka, spread on Borodino bread, paper with bay leaf vodka, Russian tapas tower, Far Eastern salmon, red caviar, home salted whitefish, lightly salted salmon, pickles, salted white milk, cap mushroom, salted salo, house style smoked roast pork, Russian salads with beef tongue, smoked pork, sausage from Krakow, chicken liver pate. Olivia. Olivia with a beef tongue. Classic forschmack. Herring with a marinated onion. And boiled potato. Grated black radish with sour cream. Sauerkraut with cranberry and aromatic sunflower seeds oil dressing. Vegetable salads with sour cream or aromatic sunflower seeds oil dressing. Russian beetroot salads with sauerkraut and Baltic spread. Herring with marinated onion, boiled potato, butter and greens. Baikal, maksun, stroganin with black salt and rye breads. Warm salad with chicken liver, spelt beetroot leaves and fermented wort dressing. Chicken liver pate with horse stewed beetroots, caramelized onion and hearth breads. Classic herring forschmack with egg pate and rye breads. Home salted onegin whitefish, onegin, I guess it's like from Lake Onega, whitefish with Baku tomatoes, grain-fed chicken in aspic with homemade horseradish and mustard, red caviar, and Russian salad with beef. That's what I'm gonna get, Russian salad with beef, like Olivia. Appetizers and salads, carp from Robshin Lakes, stuffed by old Jewish recipe with beetroots, salted white milk cap mushrooms with sour cream and garlic, marinated lamprey from Narva with cranberry and green onion. Well, Narva, that's the river. Cold smoked halibut from Murmansk, lightly salted marinated and vodka salmon with dill, boiled egg and creamy horseradish, assorted farm salo, well, pork fat served with green onions, horseradish and Borodino bread.
salmon, low salted salmon, Russian salads with Kamchatka crab and red caviar, assorted fish, jellied pike perch from Ladoga, Lake Ladoga, with quail eggs and salted cucumber, Russian Kamchatka crab salads with red caviar. Kamchatka crab. Bone marrow. Or marrow, I guess it's marrow. Okay, hot appetizers. Homemade pork sausage fried with onions. Hash browns with julienned porcini mushrooms, duck stew on pumpkin pancakes, beef marrow bones, with black salt and fried rye bread, baked phalanx of Kamchatka crab with garlic butter, that's how it looks like. Hash browns with red caviar and sour cream, breads baskets, rye bread, Borodino bread, and rustic bread served with butter. And that's tasting set menu. So here you can buy sets, like for $20 you can get a set of chicken liver pate with pork, stewed beetroot, caramelized onion, and hearth breads, Russian salad with beef tongue, hash brown with julienned porcini mushrooms, dumplings with beef and pork, beef stroganoff, onion pike, cranberry jelly with homemade crisps. Yeah, it will be like small portions, but you will get everything. I think it's actually a good idea to try this set, because this way I can show you like a lot of stuff. Set number two, it's carp from Roption Lakes, stuffed by old Jewish recipe with beetroot, Russian salads with Kamchatka crab and red caviar, stewed duck on pumpkin pancake, vareniki with potatoes. Vareniki, it's like dumplings with potato, or maybe sometimes, yes, vareniki with potatoes, it's dumplings with potatoes actually, cabbage leaf stuffs with meat, Murmansk halibut fillet with vegetables, syrnik with sour cream and apple jam. Syrnik, it's actually cottage cheesecake. And this is a wheat blini, pancakes, or like more like crepes, with sour cream, with cabbage, with cottage cheese, with meats, with red caviar, with salmon. Small pies. Pies with cabbage and egg. Pies with lamb pies. Pies with zander and green onion. Oh, caviar, yeah. Caviar, pink salmon roe, ketsa caviar, pike caviar, sterlet caviar in a jar, pike caviar, yeah, same, but just in a jar. Far East menu, weaver shrimps, cold water shrimps, Botan shrimps, Kamchatka crab leg, Far East platter. Buckwheat on samogon. Samogon like means self-made or homemade alcohol. Beef dumplings, like very traditional dumplings. Vareniki, it's dumplings but with
with potato and something like a grilled grilled pork meat, homemade dumplings and vareniki, porridges like barley porridge on cream with porcini mushrooms, buckwheat on hooch, millet porridge with raisins and pumpkins, great choto, it's buckwheat with cream. Soups, yeah, this is an awesome borscht. My favorite soup, borscht. Cold borscht with beef. Well, I like hot borscht. Chicken broth with homemade noodles and boiled egg. Okroshka on homemade kvass. Cabbage soup hangover with stewed pork breast. Mushroom kala. Pea soup with pork ribs smoked on pear wood shavings. Beef hearts, consommé with vegetables, Hungarian halasol soup, borscht, served with pork fat, rye bread, sour cream, garlic, spring onion, pots of fish, soup made of pike perch and a broth made of small river fish, and a pan of Petrov-Vodkin borscht for two persons. This is a sudak fish. Homemade pork sausage with a stewed cabbage. Main course. Okay, stuffed with meat and rice with sour cream. Tender beef liver with fried onion, garlic and buckwheat. Homemade pork sausage with stewed sauerkraut and meat sauce. Russian style beef kidneys fried with onion with creamy sauce and jacket potato. Applewood smoked pork belly served with mashed potatoes and pork scratchings. Chicken tapaka, Ural recipe. Lamb tongues with celery puree, crispy fried latiga, pike perch steak with roots and green oil, stewed lamb with millet, chickpeas and meat sauce, beef stroganoff with a nutmeg puree garnish. Also here is salmon fillet on thick sauce, a la Finnish style. Stewed beef with roast smoked cabbage and mustard sauce. Murmansk halibut fillet with sauteed vegetables on papillotes. Roast suckling pig quarter with roast potatoes, sauerkraut and pickles. Also here is dishes to share. Cutlets, like chicken cutlets with mushroom sauce and fried potatoes, beef cutlets with mashed potatoes and salt, cucumber, Kiev style cutlets with green pea puree and cranberry curran sauce. Okay, and here is desserts. Profiteroles with cream, cranberry jelly with homemade crisps, homemade apple marshmallows, honey cake, carrot cake, the cake called Anna Pavlova, sea blackthorn mousse with flax seeds, cottage cheese pancakes, blueberry cake, and baba or room with vanilla ice cream. Homemade ice cream. Okay, an artwork by Petrov-Vodkin.
У вас сейчас сеты можно сделать сет?
Да, конечно.
I think I'm gonna get a set. Вот этот первый сет, он более мясной, да, а этот более, более морской, более рыбный.
У нас сейчас вот, вот тут просто некоторого многого нету сейчас, потому что это, у нас сейчас вот, не это... вот это работает. Потому что это у нас вот, оно как бы, ну, на лето будет. Сейчас, да, у нас просто как бы не видно. Это все будет, это все будет. Ага. Обязательно будет, буквально, может быть, даже через месяц. Но пока у нас вот этот.
А, понял, вот понял. Ну, тогда мне суп, суп...
Борщ. 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 Вкусный.
Нет,
борщ.
Лучше борщ.
Борщ шикарный у нас.
Да, борщ. Борщ.
Морс. Хотите, у нас мы сами делаем морс, очень вкусный.
Да,
вкусный.
Да.
Морс.
Затем...
Сало возьмите вкусное. Фермерское.
Это у вас есть этот... Биф строганов?
Строганов нет, они как бы есть, но сейчас
понял,
нет.
А, понял,
они как бы будут. Пельмени вкусные, очень хорошие.
Сейчас, секундочку.
Да, пожалуйста.
Так, ну, борщ. Да-да, ну вот пельмени с говядиной.
Вот, очень вкусные, да, да, пельмешки, ну, хорошие. Вот именно из говядины, свинины.
Ну и котлеты... Тогда, как вы сказали, щучьи?
Щучьи возьмите, попробуйте, там котлетки или хорошие.
Да. И вот тут же еще как бы это заведение известно своими настойками.
Конечно.
Конечно. Что можете порекомендовать как самые фирменные?
Фирменные. Возьмите хреновушку хорошую. У нас хреновая настойка очень вкусная. Ну, вишневочка вкусная, она сладенькая.
Ну, давайте вот одну...
Хреновушку, да?
Хреновушку, а другую, которая... Вишневый послаще.
Да, сделаем.
Хорошо.
Сделаем. А хлеба надо?
Ну да.
Сделаем. Хорошо. Значит, у нас получилось так. У нас получилось один морс, пельмени, как горячую закусочку делаем. Да. Потом я вам несу борщ, потом котлеты щучьи. Угу. Хреновушечку несу рюмочку, да. Вишневочку рюмочку. Все.
Ну, спасибо, спасибо.
Забрать это вам
еще? Да. Надо. Так. Ну, вот это может пусть останется.
Пусть останется.
Посмотреть.
Конечно.
So that's it. That's it. I've made my choice. This is borscht. It's pike cutlets. It's tinctures because it's tapas bar. So it's not only a Russian cuisine restaurant, but it's also like pretty well known for their own self-made tinctures. The one is like more sweet. It's a cherry tincture. Another one like more sour, which is a horseradish tincture. It's based on horseradish, okay? Да. А, да, еще забыл этот оливье. У вас есть оливье,
конечно,
который без рыбы?
Конечно.
Да, вот мне такое без рыбы. So now it's time for me to wash my freaking hands and with a clean hands to wait for my order. I'll be right back, okay? I got back. So now we're gonna enjoy the Russian food experience. We will have everything: borscht, Olivia salad, also known as Russian salad, pike cutlets, cherry tincture, horseradish tincture. Dumplings, pelmeni. I guess I'd better sit here. Спасибо.
Пожалуйста. Я тогда лишний грибочек закрываю, да?
Свободен. Спасибо. It's worse. It's a berry morse, berry mix. It's a berry mixed with the water. Спасибо. And this is the tinctures. I've got the tinctures. So this one, it's a tincture based on horseradish. Yes, it's alcohol. And this one is based on vishnia, cherry. This is non-alcohol. Mors is non-alcohol. I think that this is pretty good. That Petrov-Vodkin is a restaurant where you can actually come try Russian cuisine, Russian foods, the tinctures, the original homemade tinctures. Well, I mean homemade, it means like they are making it themselves here. And listen to Russian music, Russian romances, the music that was popular in the end of 19th, beginning of 20th century, and also to find out about the about the artworks of Kuzma Petrov-Vodkin. I mean, at least if you're a curious person, so you like go to the restaurants. It's called Petrov-Vodkin, and you will ask yourself, like, Petrov-Vodkin, what it is, or who is this? And you will find out that this is one of the most significant Russian Soviet artists in the first half. In the beginning of 20th century. If you just joined, let me tell you once again that Petrov-Vodkin He is an artist, painter, and you know, he was making mostly like such iconographic works with a creative way to make the curves of the globe in the pictures. So I've got bread basket. It's a set of different breads. Meanwhile, I've got Russian salads, also known as winter salads, and also known as Olivia salads. Because, like, the guy who invented this salad, his last name was Olivia, and he worked in Moscow as a chef. It's also known as winter salad because all the ingredients you can find even at winter, which is pretty, which is makes sense for Russia, where the winter in some regions can be like a half of year. Here is an eggs, cucumber, beef meat, carrots, peas, boiled potato. You see? And this is my favorite salad. Here I think that most of Russians will tell you that their favorite salad is or Olivia or dressed herring. Dressed herring. But I think that the most will tell you Olivia, okay? Not Caesar, not Greek salads, Olivia. Ну, бон аппети. Бон аппети, так сказать. Petrov-Vodkin restaurant. We are in the epicenter of Russian culture. In front of me, there's Admiralty. Okay, Admiralty. From the right, the Winter Palace. From the left, St. Isaac's Cathedral. On my plate, truly Russian food. Bon appétit. Прекрасно. Piacere. Awesome. Россия. Ой-ой-ой.
Прекрасно.
Russian experience here. I love that they are playing like 100% Russian music here, dedicated to that era. They making a reference to. Sometimes I really hate it, like when the Russian restaurants really like having a nice interior, like really Russian foods and all this stuff. But somehow there sounds like just, I don't know, just like contemporary foreign music, which is just out of the concept, okay? Until the last drop, until the last piece. Очень хорошо, очень хорошо. So now this is pelmeni, dumplings with a beef and of course sour cream. Remember, here in Russia, here never can be too much of sour cream. Well, I mean, of course, like it's a joke, but only partly joke. Okay, and now I guess this is a tincture time, because I have a nice appetizer for a tincture. Ну, так сказать, за здоровье. Look, not на здоровье. It's somehow, I mean, it became popular that here in Russia we say на здоровье. We say za zdorovye. We never say na. Za zdorovye, like for a health. Well, it's actually kind of funny to drink alcohol for a health, because alcohol, like, not so healthy. Horse radish tincture. Хорошо, хорошо.
Actually, the guy now recommended me to eat with a spoon because there's like a nice broth inside of the dumplings. Let me show you what's inside. Inside there's just a minced beef meat. So you see, this is a dal, and it's minced beef meat. Очень хорошо, очень хорошо. Да, это не Макдоналдс. Yes, this is not a Макдоналдс. The last dumpling here. Прекрасно. Да, шикарно.
Спасибо. Сейчас будет борщ.
Так, это тоже, да, можно сюда, или как?
А давайте, я вам.
Спасибо. Чистенько. Фу, хорошо. Да. You know, when I sleep, I actually recently scratch my nose a lot. Ian Robertson, good restaurants, good food, friendly stuff. Yes, yes. Already now I can give it like 10 out of 10, because look, the location, St. Petersburg, the very center, in France, the Admiralty from the right, Winter Palace from the left, left St. Isaac's, and in the back, there's the residential building where lived Petr Chaikovsky, or okay? Moika River. When you get inside, here is an interior, pretty nice interior, of which is like depict the era of the end of 19th, beginning of 20th century. All those institutions. Next thing, you're coming here. This is 100% Russian cuisine menu. The music, also like 100% Russian, and not just Russian, but that period, which is completely like pre-revolutionary, it's like pre-revolutionary. All those romances, like now it is, you know, like the real Russian experience you're getting here. And the name of the restaurant, Petrov-Vodkin, it's named after Kuzma Sergeyevich Petrov-Vodkin, one of the most significant artists of the beginning of 20th century. Спасибо. Borscht with beef.
Спасибо.
Пожалуйста.
Прекрасно. Окей, борщ. Beetroot soup. Russian beetroot soup. That's why it has a red color. There's beef. Mm-hmm. Спасибо. Of course, sour cream. Normal borscht, I mean, in a good restaurant, which call itself Russian cuisine restaurants, borscht always goes with sour cream, onion, garlic, and pork fat. Like it, here it is. Awesome. Looks and smells just awesome. Also pepper. I drink for all of you. За вас, for you. Also pretty popular Russian toast. За вас. За вас, друзья, for you, friends. It's a cherry tincture, their firm cherry tincture. So pleasant to drink. It's a very weak alcohol, and it's sweet. So it's alcohol, but you never feel like you're drinking an alcohol. Pretty nice. Спасибо.
Пожалуйста.
Мне очень все нравится. Я вот рассказываю тоже своим зрителям, что, во-первых, это, конечно, локация. То есть, с одной стороны, Адмиралтейство, с другой стороны, Исаакиевский, там Эрмитаж. Также тут в углу жилой дом, где жил Чайковский. Во-вторых, само название Петров-Водкин. То есть, люди, которые поинтересуются, ну, почему Петров-Водкин, сразу выйдут на имя Кузьмы Петрова-Водкина и узнают побольше о, соответственно, о нем. И если копнут глубже, то о соотечественниках, в смысле о современниках, то есть это
и Илья Репин, это и Александр Бенуа. Вот, и плюс еще вот, ну, конечно, интерьер и вот музыка. Иногда бывает, что как-то расстраивает, вроде приходишь в русский ресторан, и там вроде все хорошо, но вот музыка, допустим, звучит современная иностранная музыка. А здесь все выдержано, полностью в стиле, все выдержано. Мне очень это нравится. Вам тоже спасибо. Спасибо. So, Beluga, Beluga vodka. It's now compliment, or how to say compliment? Yeah, like complimentary from the restaurants. Well, usually I don't drink vodka, but damn, I mean, I really want to refuse from the compliments. Okay. So I mix it all. Typical for me, but okay. За Россию, for Russia. Ой-ой-ой, хорошо.
У нас просто кухня в 1 часов закрывается, а ты сейчас...
Да? Да?
Больше ничего не будет заказывать, просто поворотом.
Так. Ну, думаю, нет. Думаю, все. И так очень много всего. Спасибо. So this is beetroot, beef, cabbage. Garlic bread. Thank you.
очень и очень хорошо.
Garlic with the bread is awesome, but just never do this before the dates with a girl. This is like a little butter bread with onion, fresh onion, and pork fat. Final appetizer. It's also pork fat, but it's like, how to say, like a melted pork. Smoked and melted. Borscht is done, almost done. Waiting for the next dish, which is going to be the last pike cutlets. Well, actually, I'm already feeling okay, like pretty fed, but you know, when I'm making the live streams from the restaurants, I just want to show more stuff, and for this reason, like, I have to eat more. I mean, like, I have to order more, that to show you more. Россия. Now this is the real Russia. Do they have шуба, which means dressed herring, under the coat? Dude, are you really kidding me? Are you kidding me? This is really rude to ask if they have шуба. This is Russian cuisine restaurant. And you're asking if they have шуба? So you're really asking if they have a dressed herring? Come on, dude. Hungry tuber, what song is that? Do you know to give me the correct answer? Well, just search for like Russian romances and you will find the music like this. Andrei Alks, these restaurant streams are very nice, Sergey. Yeah, it's good to see that you love it, because not every of my viewers love it, because not everybody loves to eat to see somebody eat. Okay. Also, some people are thinking that it's like sometimes it looks too bourgeois, but it's not. Actually, it's not. Why are you alone tonight, Sergey? Because my daughter, Victoria, she's having a school break. It's called spring break. And yesterday they flew away to Ufa. They are visiting the relatives in Ufa. Brianna B, the turtleneck is very bourgeois, Sergey. Well, no problem. What is the next course, Stroganov? I forgot if I ordered Stroganov. Do I really also order Stroganov? Damn. Wow. That's fun. That's fun if I also order stroganoff. King Nero, hi King. Sergey is a very cosmopolitan gentleman. How is the new channel going? It's going great, you see. You're on a new channel. It's going great. Miguel Onyx, I enjoyed read Dostoevsky. In difficult situations, Russians bring the best themselves. Dostoevsky, amazing.
А я заказывал бифстроган, я уже забыл.
Вы спросили, есть ли нет, пусть у нас сейчас их нет.
А, точно, да, точно. Все понял, понял. Okay, so I was wondering if I ordered бифстроганов. And yeah, I really wanted to order, but they said that at the moment it's unavailable, at the moment. So that's why this is the final dish. It's mashed potato and spike cutlets. The cutlets made of spike meat, I guess. Прекрасно, прекрасно. Okay, so let's finish it. These cutlets definitely having a fishy taste. Mm-hmm. Hmm. Still very hot. Petrov-Vodkin restaurant, St. Petersburg, Russia. Check out Petrov-Vodkin. Kuzma Sergeyevich Petrov-Vodkin, one of the most significant artists, painters of the beginning of 20th century. Check out the most iconic artwork from 1912. It's called Bathing of a Red Horse. It was an instant classic. It is symbolized the upcoming changes, social changes. And let me here remind you that just in 5 years after that, in Russian Empire happened the Great October Revolution of 1917. So he felt the time. Petrov-Vodkin, Kuzma Petrov-Vodkin, was born just in a small town called Khvalinsk. It's Saratov region. It's relatively not far from Samara. And he was born just in a family of a local shoemaker. From the childhood, he was interested in painting, but never thought about the real career of an artist. Even after middle school, during the summer, he got a job in a shipyard, and then he tried to get into railroads college. But fortunately for him, he failed the exams. Fortunately for him, because look, he could become just like a railroad specialist, but his real talent was in a painting, okay? Fortunately, after that, he continued his searchings in the arts, and he was noticed, and he was invited to St. Petersburg to continue his education, to get a professional education. So from 1895 to 1897, for 2 years, he studied here in St. Petersburg at the Byron Stieglitz School for Arts, and then he moved to Moscow to Moscow School for Sculpture, Arts and Architecture. And so that's where he really like growing up. One of his teachers was Valentin Serov himself, okay? And his style, he created his own style. It's like iconographic with a very creative
way of like curving the globe in his pictures. So you can, let's say, as I already told you, can check at least his like the most iconic artwork from 1912. It's called Bathing of a Red Horse. Also pretty significant pictures of him considered his autobiographical pictures of just himself, and many, many more. Here in St. Petersburg in the Russian Museum is the largest collection of the originals of his works in the Russian Museum. So check it out. And now this restaurant's named after him. Here is his pictures, like this one, and the pictures of his contemporaries. Petrov-Vodkin. Черные, black eyes or dark eyes. Well, normally I don't eat like this, but I just want you to see what I eat. I think all food here is A plus. This place for an awesome food, all the awesome foods, big time. Прекрасно. Okay, time to ask for a receipt. Можно счет.
Может быть кофе? Чай?
Да, думаю, нет. Просто морса достаточно.
Да.
И всех этих настоек.
Спасибо.
Водки.
Считай,
да?
Хорошо. Thank you.
I'm glad to see that you enjoy it. You enjoy the restaurants because I see like people only keep coming to the stream. Хорошо, спасибо.
Сейчас, секундочку, сейчас сверю. 600. Нажимаем, раз. Так.
Ничего себе. Нет, сейчас у меня тут надо сначала пароль набрать. И информацию для чаевых.
У вас какую сумму хотите оставить?
Так, ну 20% это 530.
530.
Ну 550. 550
давайте.
Прекрасно все.
Вы раньше не были?
Нет. Вот все хотел зайти, но не заходил.
Спасибо вам огромное.
Окей, вам спасибо. Вам спасибо.
Ну, приходите, нас не забывайте. Да. Сейчас это все у нас заиграет.
Да, с семьей приду еще,
да,
с семьей.
Нас надо так немножко сжато.
Хорошо. Да ничего страшного.
Все будет нормально сейчас. Потеплеет. Мы и рану здесь красиво сделаем, что у нас будет здесь.
Хорошо.
Так что приходите.
Хорошо.
Спасибо вам.
Okay, so let's look at the check. So look, 2,605 rubles, which is $35. $35 for everything. Look, Olivia with beef tongue, 308 rubles, which is a little bit, very little bit more than $5. Horseradish tincture, 95 rubles, which is like $1.30 or so. Cherry tincture, 130 rubles, which is a little bit less than $2. Morse, homemade morse, which is 170 rubles. This is a little bit more than $2. Morse, it's you remember, that's the mix of just berries with the water. Bread basket, 250 rubles, which is a little bit less than $4. Borscht with beef, it's 450 rubles, which is like a little bit more than $6. Пельмени, dumplings with beef and the pork, and the sour cream, it's 480, which is like $7. Yeah, like $7. And pike cutlets with mashed potato, 650, which is also like about, I don't know, $8. So after all, everything for all, it's $35. I think $35 for such a huge dinner, for so many dishes, borscht, dumplings, pike cutlets, Olivia, two tinctures, and also there was a compliments beluga, 50 gram of beluga vodka, which is good. And I left 20% tip, because when I film, I always leave maximum of tip. Maximum considered as 20%, so it's 550 rubles, which is about like $7. Yes, about $8, $7-$8. Okay, there we go. This was Petrov-Vodkin restaurant. I'm absolutely happy and I really give it 10 out of 10 to this place. It's 10 out of 10, dudes. It's 10 out of 10. Location, name, interior, foods, artworks, idea, and the music. You may love it or not love this music, but it's just completely, completely match the concept, and I love it. So I'm going home. So here is three halls. Look, three halls and something like also private room. Private room. That's for example, if you're planning to party with a whole campaign of your friends or your family, so you can like reserve the whole of this room. And three halls. Hall number one. Let me tell you that intentionally I came here for on Sunday night for just like 2 hours before the end of the work, because I love it where not many people, so I can film with no any problem. So look, Kuzma Petrov-Vodkin, this is his picture, well, a part of, like, yeah, I mean, like something like his picture of 1912, which is called Bathing of a Red Horse. It's a trademark of Petrov-Vodkin. Probably his the most famous artwork. So the second hall here is more like a bar. Tapas bar, you remember it's a Russian cuisine restaurant and tapas bar. So this area is more like a bar. In the moments when this is like more dining area, and there's more like a private room. Спасибо, все понравилось.
Да, вот там Петрова-Вудкина, там копия.
This also more a dining area. So the bar area is only here. There's dining, more dining style. It's also more dining style. все прекрасно.
И с собой продукты, видите, продаем какие-то вкусные, вот у нас домашние.
Ну, так-то я не очень пью водку.
А вот это кустурия, смотрите, кустурия.
Edward artwork by Кустодиев. Кустодиев же очень ценил Шостаковича. Картину покажу. It's WC. Works here as well. Aesthetics of 1920s, 1930s. Секундочку найду.
Да, пожалуйста.
Взять у меня номерочек. А, вот он. Угу. Спасибо большое.
Все понравилось?
Да, все понравилось. Локация, интерьер, концепт, музыка. Например, часто бывает, что все хорошо, а музыка почему-то... Допустим, русский ресторан, а музыка там звучит просто... Еврохит топ фори какой-нибудь. А, ну просто это выбивается с концепта.
Все сочетаться.
Да. Ну, еда тоже, конечно, в первую очередь понравилась. Настройки.
Оценили?
Да. Буду приходить с семьей еще.
Хорошо, приходите.
Все, спасибо, спасибо,
большое спасибо. Обязательно к нам приходите.
Обязательно с семьей еще приду. С семьей. До свидания. Okay, there we go. And a couple words about the location. Look. We are right in front of the Tower of Admirals here. There, St. Isaac's Cathedral. Just 100 meters from here, St. Isaac's Cathedral. And 100 meters there, the Winter Palace. The very beginning of Nevsky Prospect. Ladies and gentlemen, Nevsky Prospect.
There we go. The main square of the city. Palace Square. I think an ideal place to finish the live stream. Winter Palace, the State Hermitage, Alexander Kolon, the General Headquarters, and also here is the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Yeah, and Saxman. I hear the Saxman. He is there. He always sitting there. Okay, dear friends, thank you for watching. I think it was a pretty nice day today. I started at 6 a.m., 6 in the morning. If you never watched my live stream in the morning, I was driving all around snow with St. Petersburg because that night, I mean like today's night, was the snowfall. So I had to drive around the snow, but that was fun. And now here we got a nice Russian cuisine experience. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe if you're not yet. My name is Sergey Baklakov. This is Baklakov Live. Here I'm bringing the live streams to the whole new level. This is a live channel in real live streams, IRL streams on the widest variety of topics. See you tomorrow. The live streams every day. This is Baklakov Live. Thank you. In the end, traditional panorama. Jay Lewis. Special thanks to Jay Lewis, King Nero, Great Gatsby, Mustafa Cesar Khan, Rishab Sethi, AR, David Elias, Nightly Echoes, Ilya Karakin, Goodbye, Blue Sky, Neil McDonald's, Edster Earmark, Zenovia, Rhonda Price. See you all, as Hagemeyer. Robert DeVos. Thank you for love. Crystal, M. Jones, Petar Trachkovsky, Maria Zakharova, Cajun Guy 1950. Mama Bear, Shirley Farthing. Okay, from St. Petersburg, Russia, with love.